I mentioned in an earlier video that my wife's grandma passed away and we had to go home for the funeral this last weekend. And funerals, every time, just remind me of influence. The type of influence and the people that you influence in your life. Every time I'm at a funeral and I listen to the eulogies or I talk to people around, they all talk about the way that this person influenced their life in some way, shape, or form. Everybody that's there was impacted by the life of this person. And yeah, funerals are sad, but to me, it's so cool to see the lives that these people touched. It's amazing to me that one person can have so much influence on so many different people and can really make a difference in these people's lives. Reminds me of last year, actually at her grandpa's funeral, this guy was talking to us about how he knew Don Jelly. And he was talking about how he used to work with him back in the day at Wilmer Electric, and he would ride in the truck with Don, and Don always had his Bible in his truck. And he never tried to force religion down his throat. He never tried to, you know, convince him he was going to hell. He never, you know, it would come up every once in a while, his relationship with God and how he goes to church and those sort of things, but he never really forced it. But he had his Bible in his truck all the time, and he lived a life that just showed God and showed Jesus to this man. After he stopped working with Don, he became a Christian, and he told us that the reason that he accepted God into his life is because of the influence that Don Jelly had on his life. He then said that he got married and raised his family in the church and those same Christian values, and that his son now is a pastor of a church, and every Sunday he's preaching to people, he's getting people saved, he's encouraging believers. And I just thought, what an impact that Don Jelly had that he didn't even realize that he had, just by being an example and just by living the Christian lifestyle. And what is the impact of one person's faithfulness, you know, years down the road. And you know, when I heard these stories of her grandma and the life that she lived and her faithfulness to the church, and the way she reached out to people and new people in town that didn't know anybody, or at the church that didn't have a friend, and how she'd invite them over, and little things like preparing a meal for them, the way that she showed God's love and the way that she talked about God to everybody she knew. And it just, you think about the influence, and yeah, I think about what kind of impact am I going to have on my family and close friends? What's going to be said about me someday down the road at my funeral? That's huge, and it's a really cool big picture way to think, to live your life so that not only are there people at your funeral, but people have good things to say, and that when it's all said and done, you've left an impact on this earth and the world is better because you were here. But even on a smaller scale, in everyday situations, you influence everyone you come in contact with. And it's not always that maybe that big of a deal, but just think about the way that you are influencing the people around you. Obviously, you're gonna have a much bigger impact or possibility for impact on your family and your close friends and the people at work and the people you see every day, or if you're in leadership over somebody. But also, every person you come across, you have an opportunity to influence them for the good or the bad. If a cashier is rude with you at the grocery store, are you rude back? Or maybe the fact that they're rude is because they're going through something. Maybe their grandma just died, so they don't have the patience because they're dealing with something very heavy right now. And you being rude back to them just makes it worse. If you respond in a positive manner, maybe it'll change her whole life around. You don't know, maybe it will turn things around for them. Maybe just a smile. I just want to encourage you that, you know, the way that I try to think about it, and I'm not saying I'm perfect, but this is what I try to do, is not only live a life so that when I'm gone, I'll have made a difference in this world, but to try to live every moment of my day and every interaction with people, that every person that has any sort of interaction with me, I want their life to be better because of that interaction with me. I'm not saying we can please everybody, and not everybody is going to be happy with you, and not everybody's gonna like you, but I think we can do our part. I think I can do my best to have a positive impact on every single person I meet. And maybe you guys think that's ridiculous. Maybe you think it's not that important. You know, maybe, you know, the person you that You know, maybe somebody cut you off in traffic, and it's a pretty natural response to, you know, flip them a bird or honk or yell or whatever. But what if instead of responding in that way, what if you took a second to pray for them? Because maybe they're going through something. Maybe they're in a hurry because they're late to work. And if they're late one more time, they get fired and they got kids at home that they got to feed. And it's a lot. It's intense. I know it is. But that's where the Holy Spirit comes in to lead and guide you and to help you navigate these circumstances in life. But I just want to encourage you to look at the way you interact with people on a big scale with a lot of people, with people you see every day, but also on a small scale, the little people that you may be passing the hallway. Are people gonna be better because you were in their life? And that's something that I am trying to work on, and that's something that I try to remind myself, that every person that I come across, I have a chance to influence them, either good or bad. Are the people that I encounter better or worse because they had an interaction with Josh Coan?